Hi, it's vegan nutritionist Paul from Hench Herbivore with how not to f*** up plant-based eating for bellends. 1. Do not drink your own piss, nor anybody else's. Wee-wee comes out of our bodies for a reason. Do not, under any circumstances, try to put it back in, you sick freak. 2. Do not engage in sun gazing in an attempt to bypass the consumption of plants and get your energy directly from the sun.
I sun gazed all the time, every day. When there was a cloud, I waited for the cloud to go away and just sun gazed all the time from sunrise to sunset.
You are not a plant and you are not equipped to make this work. Just eat some food. 3. Do not starve your body by going on a water-only fast for weeks on end. This is the behavior of a mentalist. Juice fasting is a no-no also. By just drinking juice for energy, you'll not be getting any of the fiber required by your healthy gut bacteria in order for you to stand any sort of a chance of feeling well. 4. Do not severely limit your diet. Do not eat just potatoes or just bananas for months on end. Again, this is the behavior of a mental person. Do not be afraid of cooked plant foods. They are not poison. Oftentimes, the cooking of plant foods enables us to absorb more nutrients. If anyone tells you that only a diet of completely raw foods is healthful, ask them to provide the extraordinary evidence required for them to back up their extraordinary claim. When this is not possible for them, politely tell them to off. 5. If you happen to partake in magic mushrooms and the mushrooms tell you that we must eat animals in order to be healthy, don't listen to them. Those particular mushrooms are liars and do not have your best interests at heart. 6. Do not let yourself be swayed by morons. The science is on the side of whole foods plant-based eating. The proponents leading the charge are research scientists and credible doctors that are actually reversing chronic disease with this information. Those against veganism are scientifically illiterate morons. They are not qualified, they have not a shred of evidence to back up their claims, they are just Joe Blogs off the street who happens to talk to a camera and upload their drivel to YouTube. Yes, they may present person after person who failed on a vegan diet, but sadly there are many thickos out there who still confuse their left from their right into adulthood and quite frankly would f*** anything up. 7. If putting whole plant foods into your gut causes your body to have a negative reaction, then try slowly transitioning so that you give time for the pathogenic strains of bacteria to die off and the healthful strains of gut bacteria to thrive. If, after a few weeks, you are still having issues, for God's sake, run some gut tests to ascertain the reason why you can't put the healthiest foods in the world into your body without your health falling apart. Then, treat it. Yes, I'm talking to you, Tim Sheaf and Ravana. 8. Eat enough calories. Healthy whole plant foods are less calorically dense than corpses, animal secretions, and processed junk. Use an online total daily energy expenditure or TDEE calculator to work out your basal metabolic rate and your energy expenditure, and then eat that many calories. 9. Base your meals around whole plant foods and eat the range daily. Legumes, whole grains, fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, herbs and spices. These are the most nutritionally dense foods in the world. Use the Chronometer app to check nutrient intake. Foods to emphasize would be ground flax and ground chia, and also dark leafy greens. Eat the range of differently colored fruits and vegetables. If you eat too much in the way of processed foods, you risk displacing too many of the healthy foods and coming up short nutritionally.
Definitely a healthy staple to our diet, Ben and Jerry's.
Many processed plant foods are almost as unhealthy as food made from animal parts and shit that comes out of animals. And 10. Be sure to take the correct supplements. B12 is essential for vegans to supplement and needs to be supplemented by many meat eaters too. If you're not getting regular strong sunlight, then take a vitamin D3 supplement as well. Half the world has low vitamin D status. You may like to consider taking a direct DHA omega-3 supplement. However, if you eat adequately of things like flax seeds, chia seeds, walnuts and hemp seeds, and your omega-6 intake is not too high, then likely it is unnecessary. I just take it to be safe. One last supplement to consider is iodine if you don't have the cojones to eat seaweed regularly. That's it. Hopefully you are not stupid enough to f*** that up. Now click this.